campers. Still bloody windy. Just going to wrap up a few loose bits today, because tomorrow I'm heading down to Adam. We're going wild camping and doing some electrical work. So, got one more job to do. Basically, for our bed lift, I underspec'd the wire. So I used some pretty thin wire, but we actually need quite heavy duty stuff because it pulls up to 25 amps. So I've got some 6mm surface area cable here. So gonna have to run it through some conduit and then, yeah, gonna have to try and get it up through the existing channel over round and down to there. It's gonna be a bit difficult because obviously the wall's all in place now, but hopefully should be okay. So yeah, gonna put this through some conduit now, and I'll show you a cool trick. So I've got some conduit here, I've got some string, and I've got a hex socket head here. So basically I've done this before, and you attach the socket head to the string, feed that into the end of the conduit, and then if you get a hoover, you can suck the, this has enough suction to pull this, fire it through the conduit and come out the other side. Once you've got the string in, you can then obviously pull your cables through. So yeah, give it a go. I've done it not on camera, so it probably isn't going to work now. So our gravel driveway did the job, and we're off out. Afternoon campers, it's a nice sunny day, storm has gone. So it's Tuesday, I'm heading down to just near Hastings, where me and Adam are going to a campsite, and we're gonna do some bits and bobs. But for now, got a 2-hour drive, so, well, a 3-hour drive. Got myself a samosa and some mini cheddars. Here we go.
The price of Brent crude, an international benchmark, reached a 7-year high of 99.38.
So, just down in Tunbridge Wells at the Tesco car park. Adam is here, the vans are here. So we're gonna make it down to the campsite while we've still got some light. Down to the campsite, set the vans up. I've got some vegan curry to heat up. Yeah, Adam's just giving me a tour of his van, and now we're just settling in, have a couple of beers, watch the film. So, just kicking back, having a cup of tea. Adam's gone for a shower. I just knocked on him. It sounds like he had a very cold night, so yeah, getting himself warmed up. Got the little heater blowing down there. Just making some difference, and then yeah, today we're going to try and tackle the electrics. We've got a meeting with this guy Adam's buying all his electrical kit off, just up the road about midday, I think. So we'll probably try and do a little bit before then head up, meet this chap,
learn some stuff. Afterwards, do some more stuff. Then we're gonna wild camp tonight. So last night we had the heating available because we had hookup. Tonight might be a bit different, a bit colder. So
hello. It's me and Adam have just spent a couple of hours with Justin from, I can't remember the name of the company, Battery Mega something or other, which was really helpful, but kind of raised more questions than it did answer. We showed him a few of the kind of electrical bits that I bought. I've actually bought them off Amazon, and he was showing us a lot of stuff which had basically burnt out, like fuses and isolators, which were literally, it's the same kit I bought, and he was just showing us all this burnout stuff that he'd seen in other people's vans. I kind of need to get some better kit, basically, because I know that the stuff I bought is fairly cheap, but the actual batteries and inverter I bought is very expensive, and he was basically saying you're going to end up breaking your expensive kit by using cheap kit around it, which is great advice and good to have, but it means we're probably not going to be able to actually install much now until we've got that better kit. We're actually going to head to the sea, and we found a place on park for night where we can park, and we can get some food from the pub there as well. So we're going to head there now. It's about a 20 minute drive. I'm just following Adam because he knows where he's going. I have no idea. So we're going to go there, regroup, have a little think, and probably get some grub because we're hungry. So yeah, we're heading there now. So we've just parked up somewhere. Where are we?
We're near Eastbourne.
We're just like reeling a bit from all the electrical conversation we just had. So we're going to go have a pint and plan our next move.
Reset.
Warm before a freezing night in the pub car park.
Put it away. We keep it hidden. We never speak of it again. No one knows it's here, do they?
Squad is quite a good thing. Oh, hello.
Morning, campers. So, just woken up. Not a great night's sleep at all. I fell asleep in the mines of Moria.
Fool of a took.
And it rained all night. Very, 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 very windy. Yeah, this is outside the moment. Pretty wet.
So we've just left that park up because it is really coming down. So we're going to go find a toilet, find some coffee. So we've just left Eastbourne and we've come for a walk to see the Long Man. The Long Man of Shellingham. Is it Shellingham?
Long Man of Notre Dame.
Long Man of Notre Dame. So we're going to walk up. You probably get a better view from down here, to be honest. We can go. There he is, the Long Man of Wilmington, in all his glory. We've reached the summit. You fall over now. God. Unbelievable skills.
Yes.
So we just had a nice little walk up to see the Long Man, which was pretty cool. Bloody steep hill. And now we're pretty hungry because the breakfast place we went to this morning wasn't actually serving food. So we had sticky toffee pudding instead. So we're actually quite hungry. So we're gonna go get some food and then we're gonna go and try and find a nice lay-by to eat our food and finish Lord of the Rings because we both fell asleep last night watching it. So we wanna finish it off, so. So we found a nice little park up, had some lunch. And now we're gonna finish what we started. The Fellowship of the Ring. So me and Adam have just parted ways.
You'll always be with me. And you'll always be my brother.
So I've actually just knocked my wing mirror off. So evening campers, just pulling up to just move location. So we're out in Shrewsbury now, over at Anna's dad's house. Plan for one of the next jobs is to get the diesel fuel line in. So I've got 12 miles of fuel left. I'm just here now. So yeah, luckily made it because I basically want not much fuel in the tank for when we drop the tank and put the fuel line in. So yeah, but just arrived. So planning to try and get the fuel line in for the diesel heater. So the fuel tank's basically underneath here in the van. It's there. So planning on coming up through the floor here and then going behind the units to the heater, just so the cable's all there, the line's nice and safe and in the van. A faffy morning. Had to disconnect one of the cables from the Truma, which was a bit of a nightmare to be honest, but yeah, managed to get the diesel fuel line through the van. Hello everyone. So we're currently just trying to fit our diesel fuel line. So that involves dropping the tank down slightly so we can get the new tube in. But it's bloody difficult. These are bloody tight, these bolts. Yeah.
Oh shit, it just keeps going down.
I actually think it's okay because it's supported by me.
Yeah.
You know, Dan was saying he did it on his chest.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I can see it. Can you pass me my phone? I think it's in the van.
Yeah, I think
And can you get me a Stanley knife blade?
Stanley knife.
just the blade, I think. So you can just about see it in there. It's that little nipple thing. So I just need to get the drink tube on that. Let's see from the other side. All right. Oh yeah, there we go. Ow.
I hope you didn't record that.
So great success, we've managed to get the fuel line in to the fuel sender on top of the tank. So we have both sides now, so I need to connect these up where we're going to mount the pump, which is going to be up here somewhere. So yeah, I need to chop these back and then yeah, get it cracking. So I'm just setting up the fuel pump. So this is going to sit underneath the van on this bracket. And then the fuel hose comes in from the fuel tank. This pumps the fuel up the line, and then this line goes up through the floor and off to the heater. And then it's got a electrical connection which gives it power and tells it to pump. So there we go, that's the fuel line done. So it comes out from underneath the tank, goes to the pump, comes up through the floor. Around the back, down here, through there, and into here, just like that. So that was a very successful day on the van build. Getting the diesel fuel line in was a huge milestone. One of those things that was absolutely terrifying before we did it, but it was a bit tricky, but fairly straightforward, just getting access to it. So relieved that's done. So I'll see you all in the next video, where we're going to be tackling a million and one odd jobs left. If you'd like the video, like it, obviously. If you want to subscribe, you can subscribe. Talk to you on the next time.